Children need to learn language only from their own experiences. They don't get to use the internet to look up things and use the large amount of data there. We've seen remarkable advances in state-of-the-art AI systems in the last few years. One reason they're especially powerful is that they are just trained on astronomical amounts of text gathered from the internet. This is often on the order of a million times more than any single human ever receives in their lifetime. This makes the comparison to humans very challenging.
Children conservatively would take about 100,000 years of experience in order to reach those numbers in terms of the amount of words that they would hear just in their natural environments.
For babies, and you know, one of the main motivations underlying this particular work is the question of reference, really. And reference means when a baby hears something like the word cup, how do they know that it refers to something like this and not anything else out there in the world? It could mean this kind of object. It could mean orange things. It could mean things with a hole in them. In fact, researchers, you know, have argued that there are infinitely many possibilities, and searching through an infinite space seems impossible in practice.
In a way, the ideal test would be to train an AI system not on astronomical amounts of data from the web, but through the eyes and ears of a single child when they're learning in their everyday environment. And that's exactly what we did in this study.
So the data was collected by placing a sort of a tiny camera that was strapped onto an infant from starting at 6 months to 25 months of age.
Ready?
And they were recorded in hour-long play sessions on a semi-weekly basis, leading to a few hundred hours of video.
We didn't want to pool data from many children together because a child has to learn about the world, has to learn language with only their own input. They can't share their input with their friends. So we analyzed the multimodal AI system in a variety of different ways, and we found for the first time that an AI system trained on just subsets of a single child's input is able to learn some words in everyday environments. The system was able to learn to map words to visual reference, or words to the objects in the world that they're being referred to.
An interesting failure case we found in our model is that it didn't pick up certain concepts, one of them being the concept of hands. We noticed that the word hand often really only got mentioned when the baby was playing at the beach. And so we found this interesting mismatch where the model was associating the word hand with sand instead. And that was an interesting case where you know, some of these model failures sort of highlight the sort of limitations of the data that we have.
I was surprised how much today's AI systems are able to learn when exposed to quite a minimal amount of data of the sort a child actually receives when they're learning language. What we discovered here was that learning-driven approaches, associative learning approaches, when combined with the ability to learn features of your environment, can get further than common thought.